1 2 3 start.
Good morning all of you. Today we will be discussing about topic called as global positioning system. So global positioning system. This is one of the mostly used wireless kind of application nowadays. So basically GPS is a satellite-based navigation system which able to find out the exact location on the Earth. You want to see particular location, how to read, how to just happen, all these things are there. Those information with visual also able to see by this operation is called as global positioning system. Okay. So this what let me go with the what is the GPS mean by and what is the importance of this GPS is, so what will you get, means what is the outcome of this GPS. So the outcome of GPS will give you the navigation type of outputs, that means particular location on Earth or above Earth, you know, like not only on the land, it can be on air as well as sea also, what is happening, all this can be navigated through the satellites. Okay, right. So here the whatever the array of satellites, I told you this GPS will function based upon the satellite operations only. So without satellites, there is no navigation to the GPS. So the array of satellites, right, will give you information in time coded data from the satellite to the ground station. By which way? Means the time coded data will give you in terms of longitudes as well as latitudes. So if you give the data in terms of longitude latitudes, you can able to observe the navigate on the land. So we want to see the navigation on sea now. Our more thing we need to have for this called as altitude. So this is if you want to see the navigation on sea. So these are the basic information is encoded, that is transferred from the satellite which is there above of the Earth to the ground station, where you control the completely data through which you will be having navigation. So let's see one by one what is exactly operation and what is happening in the GPS. So before we will discuss this thing, I would like to give you what is the how the GPS is existing in the operation. So in 1974, okay, 1974, the US government, US Defense Department of Defense, Department of Defense is initiated or developed this global positioning system. Earlier it was called as NASCAR or Navigation Star, it called as NASCAR. Whenever it is initiated this process, now it's called as NASCAR. So it started in 1974 and it is completely functional result at 1994. It means there are 20 years of time it took to complete full-fledged GPS operations. Okay, the time of US government, you want to see the navigation, what is happening on their land or the on the territories as well as the different territories also. So for navigation purpose, they have started this thing. Okay, this GPS operation is started. Likewise, like the US government is having this NASCAR, as I mentioned, NASCAR, or now we call it as GPS. Likewise, different countries is having their own navigation operations. So likewise, India is having its own navigation system called as IRNSS. You may call as NAVIC. It's also called NAVIC. And then that will be finding out thing. So this way only, this is taken from the Sanskrit word. So I am nothing but Indian Regional Navigation Satellite Systems. So similarly we have Europe is there, Europe countries have its own navigation system, it is called as Galileo. And similarly we have Japan is having its own navigation system, it is called as Japan. As well as China is having its navigation system and Russia is having its navigation system. So Russia is corresponding to likewise, name is given to a different countries. So to just talk about before going to the explanation of the community GPS, I give you introduction the how this IRNS system exists. So IRNSS, Indian Regional National Navigation Services System, in 1999 when we had a war with Pakistan. So we used to have this navigation where the weapons are there, where the navies are there for the Kargil war, means between the Pakistan and India. So 1-5 up in there. So that time India is not supported well to by the US, by its GPS. Because of that, lost something as a part of the soldiers as well as some different sounds. So after finishing the little of the Kargil war against us, so that time Indian government is initiated to have our own navigation systems to have protection from the now observed people of the countries as well as the to know what is happening on the territories of India only. So I tell you one thing, this IRNSS is purely for the Indian navigation only. We don't have this navigation to see in different countries what is happening in their land. Whereas this GPS is there based upon US there, this is now having command, at least having the possibility to see different countries territory what is happening there also. Now this is purely for the Indian territory navigation system. So that time India started off operation 1999, it is ended completely with full threats in 2018. So India map system IRNSS, you may call as Navigna, it is having totally operational satellites are 7, okay, and 2 space satellites are there. These are the space satellites are there, and this is nothing but the operational satellites. So among which we have 4 are GEOs and 3 are GSOs. Geo Earth orbit and the geostationary orbit. So these are there combining the information to the ground station. So likewise, these are the own setup of its navigation system. This is what the but Indian navigation system. Now we will see the exact what is the GPS and how it is going to implementing operation in the question. So I told you this GPS is having a satellite based navigation system. Okay? So it is having this GPS generally having 3 types of the segments we call as they are satellite segment, second one is control segment, third one is called as user segment. Satellite segment, control segment, user segments. So what is satellite segment? So satellite segment is that it is the segment which existing on air. Okay, the segment which existing on air. Whereas control segment is the existing on land, from where your all the territory type of information or surrounding type of information is gathered and transmitted by satellite to give you exact GPS locations on Earth. It will be on Earth and we see also. So you are looking for, so it is receiver only. This is actually a receiver completely act as a receiver only. So where if you want to have something location on Earth somewhere else, now, that is what your user. Okay? So whatever the information you want, a particular area, na? So you give the information that will be navigated by the satellites with the help of the control segments. Okay? So let's see what is satellite segment mean by. So in satellite segments, na? In this especially the GPS. GPS is having totally 24 satellites are there. So 24 satellites are there. So each means you'll be having 6 orbits. Other paths. In each path you will have 4 satellites. Like that you will have 24 satellites. So each path will be having 6 paths are there around the earth like this. So this is the earth now. We will be having 6 paths. 1, 2, 3, then 4, 5, 6. Like this you have 6 paths are there. In each path, take an example of this path. This path is having four chakras at a time. That means one chakra, two, three, four. So if when you ask a particular navigation, all these four chakras will give you information. Their input data is given in the receiver, which are being asked. So like this, they have 24 chakras and three chakras are in scale. These chakras are in scale. Like in India, we have two chakras. So always these chakras are there in scale. If any other chakras are only 24 chakras are the damage, those will be implemented with this spare chakras. So there is no matter of the what you call delay of the giving information in the GPS operations. So here each orbit, or if you call as each satellite map, the orbital time, we call as orbital time, that means how much rotation it rotates around the Earth. Okay, means it is around 12 hours is the orbital term. So approximately 11 hours 58 minutes only exact time is asked, but approximately 12 hours orbital time to take. Means two times a day, a satellite will rotate two times a day around the Earth. So that means of cost is going to be traveling around the Earth. So it will give you information that is accurate. So whenever the information is provided, the provided information not only by the single satellite. Okay, this the information is provided by the accumulation of the these four satellites. Accumulation data of these four satellites. That's why we always get the exact location where you want to ask the question. Even the navigation happen in the particular area, it means momentum of the vehicles you call us, or change of something, environment you call us, or any unauthorized or any fastidious things are there, which is going to be just moving there. The, all those things accurately navigated by the type of information is covered by this GPS type of applications. So the most important thing is that how to provide the information. So I told you there are information of the navigation is provided by the satellite by landings as well as the latitudes. Landings as well as the latitudes. So generally we know, right? If you want to focus, you want to see a particular part in any thing on Earth, it is based upon the landing value as well as the latitude value. So this pinpoint location is exactly where you are focusing or where you want to navigate properly on Earth. Okay? So these things, you have to provide the landing as well as the latitudes out of the four satellites. I told you, out of the four satellites, we have four satellites are there in each orbital. So three satellites are specially for this purpose. Provide the landing value as well as the latitude value. So it won't provide anything, show you the visualization of the location. Means what is happening there, visualization location by this three satellites with respect to its landing value. For example, this is the Earth. So you are focusing on particular point. So landing wise, latitude wise, whatever the four satellites are there, 1, 2, 3, 4, these four satellites will be focused on it. So what is happening? So it will give you, if any vehicle is there, the momentum of vehicle is there, the momentum of vehicle is going to be shown momentum wise only, like V only is a variation of the landing latitude wise. Okay? Right. So apart from that, if you are going to be navigating the operation on the sea, apart from latitude, you should have the altitude also. How much altitude or nothing but how much height above the sea level is there, that has to provide. This is provided by the fourth satellite. So among the four, these satellites covers always the latitude value. The fourth satellite is there. The fourth satellites will provide you the altitude values. So that way we are going to find out exactly what is the latitude value, and what is the altitude value. Maybe on Earth, or maybe on sea also. So see here, when your data is transferring, when data is transferring from the satellite, that data is going to coming by two ways. You call it the L1 transmission or L2 signal. So L1 signal is generally for general application. It is something 15.12 megahertz of the signal is used, and the speed of transmission is like 1 Mbps, and it is used BPS transmission step off. No transferring data. Okay. Similarly, here also it is going to 47 megahertz of signal is used for transmitting data and the desired 10 Mbps. So what is the difference between these two? This is for the generalized purpose applications. This is for the particularly MBP application. Though it is initially designed for the military application of the GPS, so the same thing is done for the general application also. This whatever using GPS now, it is using L1 channel. So it is having timing data, whatever data coming from satellite is having time encoded data, plus it is consisting of FRMA data, time for encoded. So it is equal to alignment. The satellite is going to align with the alarm clock of the satellite as well as the control segment is there on the bell curve. So this combination of these things will give you data in the encoded format. Okay. Similarly, FRMA data. What is this FRMA data nothing but? FRMA data nothing but whatever retrieval type of information, right? Which has something like control things are the earth. For example, this is the earth, right? We have different areas of the control elements. So if you want to locate in one navigate this value or navigate this area, right? So the information about this land or information about this area has to be covered by this control segment which is there at the earth. May be provided by this control segment, or else this control segment have to give information across to the satellite. So that data is called as the FRMA data. So FRMA data is provided by the control segment. Accordingly, you only exactly look at the what is the longitude value as well as the what is the latitude value. Whereas comes the receiver, it is like generally we will be having super heterodyne receiver. Super heterodyne receiver is used. So here complex type of super heterodyne receiver is used in the GPS operation. Okay, so we have a lot of things are there, and we have where it comes to the applications now. As we know, applications is basically this GPS is made for the military applications. It is designed, but we can use the same thing also the navigation and ships. Navigation on ships as well as navigation on road and navigation on air also. So navigation is possible by all means. So one thing I can tell you that the GPS is an initial type of the navigation systems which provided the navigation operation on earth, what is happening and how it is going to be taking information is by this value. I told you latitude value as well as the latitude value. This is generally basic information regarding the GPS system. Thank you.